Tippy time, my damies, and welcome back to the channel. Today's build centers around doing what Zavala said we should be doing. We are the wall, we are the front line, we are the Titan. We are running the Warded Dawn class. This is a frontline guardian build. I want to be up in the enemy spaces, and I want to be making wells for the rest of my team so I can keep them ability spamming. I had originally intended on using the Heart of the Most Light for this build, but I found with the aspects and fragments available to us that I had my abilities pretty much the entire time regardless. And seeing as this season focuses around the Hive stealing our light, I figured I'd steal some Hive tech and use the Wormgod Caress. So what are we going to need for this build? First up, we're going to be using the Bastion fragment. Cast your super to grant overshield. Casting barricade also grants overshield. This will also allow us to slowly regen our overshield once it's broken. Having this overshield can be great in a couple of different ways. It's good to pop an overshield before you go into combat, give you that extra bit of safety. It's also good when you realize you've gone a little bit too far, you just pop it and get yourself a little bit safer. This pairs beautifully with the offensive bulwark void aspect, as this is going to allow us to regen our grenades faster and for our melees to do increased damage. We pretty much lay down a shield to get our buff going. We stick a little close to it, it's going to help us regen our grenades pretty damn quick. And if anybody comes near to our barricade, we're just going to punch them in the face and get that increased damage. You can see here it's just perpetually repeating itself with our abilities. Die, Knight, die. I've had a bit of trouble finding this melee buff, as I tend to have 5 buffs going on at once and it's a little hard to keep track of, but I think it's 30%. Echo of Persistence. This is just going to buff the duration that we have our overshield applied for, which is very handy. We will be running a hands-on mod and melee wellmaker, as we are Titan and we are going full meathead and chucking lots of shields. I'm not sure if it's a glitch or not, but I find that uncharged melees when I have the void overshield are still granting me the wells, and the throwing shields are when I have the charged melee, of course. We are running the melee kickstart mod. This is a stasis mod. This will help me get 20% of my melee energy back upon throwing. We are also running elemental ordnance. This is our second form of getting wells made for myself and my teammates. You can see here, and chuck one grenade, get 3, gonna get another grenade out and get another 3. The Wormgod Caress is a really fun exotic to run. A lot of this build was focused around trying to make my sentinel shield as strong as possible, and with these I can do that. As standard, without the buff from the overshield or from a 1-2 punch shotgun, I can do 35 times the initial damage of a melee just using these exotics alone. Going from a base punch here at 7,000 all the way through to 272,000 DPS for one throwable shield. For our chest piece, we're running another elemental ordnance and then a bunch of dampeners to take less damage, as we are right up in their grills. A series of scavengers as required, but the main thing here is bountiful wells to grant additional wells on ability kills. This is why I'm running a second melee wellmaker. We're also running suppression mastery, but I'll probably swap this out for Suppressive Darkness inside of in-game content, and Energy Vamp for additional ability regen. I've been running the Hake shotgun with Subsistence Demolitionist, way to get more grenades and not worry about those pesky reloads. I believe the shotgun has a 9-meter one-kill range inside of PvP, but this might be a glitch, so I dare say I'll come back in line with the rest of the shotguns once Bungie figures this out. Could pair this build with something like the Die Side for some more powerful DPS, but I've been running the other one primarily as I'm just trying to clear and help my teammates out as much as possible. I've paired this with the Sleepless rocket launcher, auto-loading demolitionist, as somebody in your fire team is always going to have a Gjallarhorn, and the BXR Battler with blunt execution rounds, hitting this gun's next shot 500% increased damage after a melee kill. For the last two fragment slots, I have been using Echo of Provision and Echo of Leeching, but feel free to swap these out for whatever you might like. I'd like to give a quick shout out to Lord Habicado, King Meathead Titan himself, for helping to inspire this build. Anyway guys, that's the build for today. Hope you enjoyed this monster. Please don't forget to hit that like, hit that sub if you're new, and I'll see you on the next one. Tippy time, my damies. What a tie. Bottom of everything, he's the most tip-top.